Well, there's a look at Manny Legace 2002. I think the sweater adds a little bit of weight too, I gotta tell you. You guys wore tents back there between you and when Ozzy had it, but look at that. How beautiful is that? Manny Legace, now the goaltending coach for the Columbus Blue Jackets. Now, due to COVID protocol, we're both wearing our masks. Yes. However, you wore a mask for most of your career, so you should be okay with that, but this is a different protection. You are a lot lighter now. Due to COVID, you lost 30 pounds. Mm-hmm. Due to your wife, Gigi, yep. You're here with us to tell us about it. This was the month of August. What happened?
So we got COVID from people we were visiting after they got their baby, and she got it 2 days before I did, and you know, her followed her. Basically, she got hot one day, she got cold the next day, and I was basically on the same thing. And then by day six or seven, she got a cough. Six or seven, I got a cough. By day eight, hers went away. Mine never went away. And couldn't sleep, couldn't that. And then one day she's like, you're going in. I'm like, I'm not going to the hospital. I got a cough.
Because you're stubborn.
Yes, I'm stubborn as, you know, your dad back in the day. It's like, rub some dirt on it. I'm not going for this cough. I'll be fine. You're fine. I get this cough anyway when I have allergies. She's called the doctor back in Columbus. Then she called Dr. Clucci, and Dr. Clucci's like, get him in. There's something going on, and Dr. Clucci, Red Wing doctor, famous for helping out Yuri Fisher, and still a great friend of ours, and play a lot of golf together, and he's like, just bring him to an ER, don't have to come see me, just bring him in and get in. And I'm like, if I'm going in, I'll go see Doc. So we drove, you know, the 50 minutes to go see Doc, and it was the best thing I did, and my old wife saved my life, and...
You had blood clots, right?
Yeah, I had blood clots. It developed. We don't know if they developed from COVID or I had them before, but it enhanced it with the cough and the pneumonia that everybody gets. And Dr. Clucci and Dr. Hussein and the whole staff up in the ICU unit at Henry Ford Macomb saved my life. And if it wasn't for my wife, I wouldn't be here. But if it wasn't for the hospital staff and the ICU staff and Dr. Clucci and Dr. Hussein, I wouldn't be sitting here right now.
Well, you lost 30 pounds. How do your shins look?
It's my wife, because we have a legacy trait. Like, we're all lower butt, yep, legs and calves. And she goes, your legs are disgusting looking. They're like two strings hanging from your shorts.
You'd never seen them before,
no,
had you?
I'm like, I've never seen my shin before.
Well, from COVID, the month earlier, daughter Sabrina, July 4th weekend, gets married. Tell me about Sabrina.
Sabrina's one of my heroes in my life. She's been battling this. She's a nurse in Grand Rapids, and she's been battling this COVID and working relentlessly with the staff up there, and she's a hero of mine.
Well, that weekend, July 4th, when your daughter got married at your home, I know what it's like to lose a son. Unfortunately for you, Matiss Kivlenieks, your goaltender, he passed in a fireworks accident at your home the same weekend your daughter got married.
Yes.
I'm sure Matiss is looking down now, seeing you, Manny. Tell me about him.
Yeah, we're not even close to even getting over this. It's his wife, my wife and I are, he was a kid to us. He lived with us through the pandemic. Every summer he lived with us. You know, he's from Latvia, and you know, he became really close to my kids, my nephew, our whole family. He just became one of our family, and I couldn't even fathom what you went through, and obviously it wasn't my kid. His parents were nice enough. He was cremated to go home. His parents were nice enough to let us have some ashes, and we got to put him in our mausoleum spot where my wife and I have our spot, and we still get to see him, and we're not even close. And you know, I know you.
No, I understand.
Yeah, and we're not even close. It's just,
no.
It was on my daughter's wedding, and we've been doing the fireworks for 17 years and never even had someone burn a finger. So this is
terrible, tragic accident, and you can't explain it, but you're a wonderful guy. I know the hockey world rallied around you.
Yes, they did.
And I know you love Matiss, and I hear what Elvis loves you and how great you are with all your guys and your team and Torts and Brad Larson. And
I couldn't have done it without Lars and Torts and and our training staff, like everybody in the hockey world, and you know, just calling Joey Kosher and the whole, even the Blue Jackets were, they took care of everything. They were, what they did in the McConnell family for Matiss and his family is far, they took care of every aspect of what was going on, and you can't say enough about what they did for him.
Thank you, Manny, for sharing that.
Thank you.
I know it's hard.
Thank you.
Thank you. Continue to this year with your team. And we may call it a rebuild. We're both in the same situation. We're getting there. Thanks for doing this,
Thank
Manny.
You,
Great seeing you again. And you look wonderful.
Thank you
wonderful. Thanks, pal.